In this video, we are going to see one more example of components of force in three-dimensional force system. Let us read the statement of the problem. A rectangular plate is supported by three cables as shown in figure. Knowing that the tension in cable AB is 450 Newton, determine the components of force exerted on the plate at B. Please note this point. Components of force exerted on the plate at B. Note down the statement. Now see, this is the rectangular plate having dimensions 900 millimeters length and 720 millimeters width. This plate is supported by three cables, AB, AC and AD, and all the three cables are anchored at point A. Now the tension in the cable AB, is 450 Newton, and you have to find out the components of the tension exerted at B. Now the magnitude is 450 Newton, and what is the direction? So the tension in the cable AB, and we have to resolve the components at point B. So the direction of tension is from B to A, right? And the magnitude is 450 Newton. Suppose if it is asked, resolve the force of 450 Newton, that is the tension in the cable AB at point A. Now the direction of tension will be from A to B. So this direction is very, very important. Now to find out the components of this F, let us write first the force vector. So force vector can be written as the magnitude of force into unit vector. So this force is acting along the line BA. So you have to write unit vector along BA. Now what is the magnitude of force? It is 450 into, how do you write unit vector along BA? So it is the position vector along BA divided by its magnitude. To write the position vector, you must know the coordinates. So let us write first the coordinates of points A and B with respect to the origin. As I said before, the dimension lines in the figure, they are parallel to either x, y or z axis. Now to write the coordinates of point A, point A is on y axis. So the other two components, that is x and z, are 0. So we have 0. And y coordinate of A, see the dimension line parallel to y axis, that is 480 millimeters. So the y coordinate is plus 480 and the z coordinate is 0. Is it clear? Now the coordinates of point B. So this point B is in xz plane, horizontal plane. Plate is in xz plane and point is on xz plane. So its y coordinate is 0. Okay, now to write the x coordinate of B, see the dimension line parallel to x axis. So this is our x axis. So the line parallel to x axis of point B with respect to the origin, see here, it is 320 millimeters. And we are taking this as positive x axis, positive y axis and a positive z axis. So this point B is located on the negative side of x axis. Am I right? So the x coordinate is here minus 320, y is 0 and z. See the line parallel to z axis. So distance of point B from the origin, so it is 360 millimeters. It is the line parallel to z axis and it is on the positive side. Okay, so it is plus 360. Understood? Now we have the coordinates of A and B. Now you tell me, what is the unit vector along BA? So it is A minus B. Coordinates of A minus coordinates of B, 0 minus into minus plus 320. So 0 plus 320 I plus 480 minus 0 J plus 0 minus 360 K divided by square root of 320 square plus 480 square plus 360 square. Now do the calculations. Now we have F bar is equal to I plus 317.65 J minus 238.23 K. Right? Done? Now here I coefficient will give you the X component, J coefficient is Y component, and K coefficient is Z component. So we have now X component of force. Fx is 211.76 Newton. Y component 317.65 Newton. And Z component is minus 238.23 Newton. So these are the components of 450 Newton force along X, Y and Z axis. Now calculate the angles. Theta x is equal to cos inverse fx upon f. Fx is 211.76 and f is 450. Similarly, theta y is equal to cos inverse fy 317.65 upon 450. And theta z is cos inverse fz minus 238.23 upon 450. So we have theta x 61.93, theta y is 45.1 and theta z is 121.96 degrees. Is it clear? Now, let us write the coordinates of points C and D also. It is not asked, just for practice. Yes, you tell me now, what are the coordinates of point C? First, you have to see whether that point is in a particular plane or on a particular axis. So here, the point C is in XZ plane, that is horizontal plane. So the Y coordinate will be 0. Now to write the X coordinate, see the dimension line parallel to X axis, that is 450. So it is plus 450. It is on right hand side. So 450, Y is 0. And Z, see the line parallel to Z axis, so it is 360, it is on positive side, plus 360. Tell me now, coordinates of point D, again D is on XZ plane, so Y is 0, and to write the X coordinate, see the line parallel to X axis, 250, it is on the positive side, so it is plus 250, Y is 0. And Z is the line parallel to Z axis. Now we are taking this as positive Z axis, negative Z axis. So this point D is behind the X axis. So it is minus 360. Okay? Thank you.